I'm Matthew Diglio from FiascoSports.com reporting for the SA Footballer magazine. Now I'm here with Rod George of the Broadview Footy Club. Welcome, Rod.
Welcome, mate. How you going?
Good, thank you. Now I want to find out a little bit about your journey in footy.
Okay, my journey began back in high school. I tried out with the Nurg under 17s when I finished high school. That didn't last too long due to a knee injury from high school, and because I lived in the wrong zone, I lived in the Port Adelaide zone, so that was the end of that. Gave it away for a few years, then some mates of mine that I grew up with encouraged me to come out and join the Athelstan Football Club. I was out there for 3 years. Last year we only won one game, so I wasn't enjoying it that much, even though we had great time off the field and I wanted to be part of a winning team. So one of the guys I was working with encouraged me to come out to Broadview, and I've been there since 1988.
Wow, so you've been there quite a while. Now, I know there's a lot of pride for you and also a long family history at the Broadview Footy Club.
Yes, on both sides of the family. My mum's cousin started there just after the war in about 1947. And on my dad's side, his father and his uncle played there during the 1930s. They were part of North Adelaide. So when they didn't get a game with North Adelaide in their reserves, they came over to Broadview, as they only lived about a street away.
Wow, great to hear such, you know, great history in your family. Now, I want to find out some of the sponsors of the Broadview Footy Club.
Yeah, we have some great sponsors at our football club. Bob Carlier from Cowden Insurance, Peter Godrick from Cabinet Tech. The Tired Tigers are great sponsors of our club, do a lot of fundraising over the years, and Jamie Hatchard from Denron Metals.
All right, great to hear, because, you know, clubs like this always need sponsors. Are there any upcoming functions as well that you have at the footy club?
Yes, we have a couple of upcoming functions. We have what we call as our last man standing, which is sort of like a reverse raffle. That's coming up in the next couple of weeks. And then towards the end of the year, in our last home game for the year, will be past Players Day, in which we were looking at having some special heritage jumpers, which we're working on at the moment, being available for all members of the club.
Wow, that's pretty cool. Heritage jumpers, can you tell me a little bit more about that?
We're working on something to sort of recognise anyone who's played at least 100 games for the club. So we're quite fortunate in that area. We've got at least 246 players who have played a minimum of 100 games for the club. We've got one in the 400 club, about 11 in the 300 club, and about 50 in the 200 club. So, and all the rest is made up of guys who played a minimum of 100 games.
Wow. Well, that's great news as well. Thanks very much for the interview today, Rod.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.